What's up, guys? Welcome to the first episode. I mean, like, technically the first episode. I don't know. I did a first, like, look at for this game. Anyway, we're back. The Riftbreaker. It's a top-down action kinda RPG. It's mostly just an action game. But anyway, base defense, turrets. You know, if you're looking for an action-packed thrill ride that goes a million miles an hour and totally, you know, likes explosions and stuff, then you know what? This is the game for you. I already played the prologue, so I'm not going to do that for this stream and for this official series. If you guys want to see that, you can see the video I posted, you know, a week or two ago, however long ago it was. Too long. Anyway, let's do this new campaign. We're going to go ahead and do this. From what I've been told, the difficulties on this game are easy is actually normal. Normal is hard. Hard is harder than hard. And brutal is you're going to die. So, fun. We're going to go ahead and play normal because for some reason I feel the need to not play easy because, I don't know, I just don't. Anyway. Let's go ahead and do this. First off, what's hardcore mode? Removes the ability to respawn when Mr. Riggs has destroyed its game over. Recommended only for super experienced players. We're not going to be doing that. That's going to be tough. So let's go ahead and do this. Should I let the cutscene play out? I'm pretty sure I can skip it. I mean, you guys probably all saw this if you watched the prologue episode. I don't really want to watch it again. So I'm just going to start it. Let's go ahead and do this. People have been waiting long enough for this game. I don't think they need to wait an extra couple minutes for the opening cinematic. I'm playing this on PlayStation 5. If you guys weren't aware, I think, actually, this is only on the current gen systems, i.e. PlayStation 5 and Xbox Series X. Oh, yes. Left hand, right hand, you know, as long as I know where my hands are. Okay, so.
Riftjump successful. All systems check. Gravitational strength, 1.05 G. Atmospheric pressure within safe levels. Magnetic field check. Error. Repeat magnetic field check with stationary equipment. Star system positioning check. Milky Way galaxy. Sycorax belt. Planet Galatea 37. Ashley, we have arrived.
Welcome to Galatea 37, Mr. Riggs. It's so beautiful here. Virtual simulations on Earth were good, but this is amazing. An alien tropical paradise, and we're the first humans to experience it.
I'm not exactly human.
I was just going to say that.
And the paradise part is also left to be determined. Remember your training, Ashley. We should set up a base as soon as possible.
You could at least pretend to be human. Just a bit. But you're right. There's no going home until we can construct a functioning Rift Station. Let's start with the basics.
Ashley, construct a headquarters building to secure our presence here. It will allow me to reconstruct if my armor is destroyed.
We don't have enough carbonium to build an HQ. Let's scout for a deposit and set up our base close to it. We need to move quick. It's probably a matter of time before the natives spot us.
Okay, so I'm gonna be letting them do the talking. Oh, hey, little mama. I'm a little late from the 2 o'clock time I told you, but hey, you know what? I was eating a burger and some fries, and I'm here. Also, just got finished watching you know, a couple of everything great with you know, movies and stuff. You know, the YouTube channel. You might have heard about it. Everything great. You know, anyway. Yeah, I'm gonna let these, characters say all the stuff they're gonna say, and, I think I'm gonna turn the music down. It's a little loud in my earballs. Let's go ahead and do this here in settings, and audio, and I know it doesn't sound as loud. Okay, does it sound loud, Lil Llama? I'll turn some of this stuff down. Like, the dialogue and stuff, I don't super duper care about that. But, anyway, let's do that. That's better. That's not nearly as loud in the aforementioned earballs. Anyway, so, right. Here we are on Galatea. This alien planet. Super duper neato. I played, I don't know, maybe 2 or 3 hours of the prologue. Music sounded like you had to, yeah, no, it was a little loud. So that's probably why it sounded like I was yelling. But anyway, yeah, I probably played like maybe 2 or 3 hours of the prologue. Hello, Moobot. What are you? Oh, okay. That's fine. Oh, I gotta log into the thing. Whatever. I can still see the chat. It's not a big deal. Oh, I shouldn't have killed that one. That was a friendly thing. Okay, so anyway, let's go ahead and do this. So, our main goal here is to basically colonize a planet. We're trying to terraform, and we're the first people here on the planet. So that's what our job is. Oh yes, I know.
Let's place it close to a carbonium deposit. This will help us speed up resource production.
So as you can see, every once in a while we're running into little pockets of aliens. Those are going to be our main enemies that we're going to have to deal with here. Whilst we gather supplies, defend it, build a base, and just keep on keeping on, generally speaking. I'm going to be spending a bit of time walking around trying to figure out where the heck I want to build a base. Because right now, they're not giving us like a, you're going to die in 2 minutes kind of a countdown or anything, so I'm not going to worry too much about it for the time being. Pretty sure we regenerate HP and all that, so we can just kind of hang out. Okay, maybe we don't regenerate HP, but we definitely have a shield that regenerates, so we'll have to figure that out. You've seen I've run through a few resource patches here and there. Ironium and carbonium, those are our main resources that we're dealing with right now. Those are used for various buildings and things and stuff, and you'd be able to figure that out, because you're smart. You're real smart. You're watching this video, and you're just a smart cookie, aren't you? Anyway, let's continue massacring the local population, and, yeah. See what we can see. I don't know if we're getting anything from breaking these. We're getting plant biomass. I see that. The plant biomass, we can use that in, I believe, a facility or a building that we can create a little bit later that will give us power generation. So we're going to have to also worry about power generation quite a bit. It's one of the things that in this game you can't skimp on. Very important. Okay, so right now I'm kind of looking for a natural formation, like caverns, caves, something like that. Something to give me a tactical advantage against these various creatures. Okay. So far I'm not really seeing anything that's kind of jumping out at me as a wonderful place. See some of the different types of creatures we're going to be fighting. Some of those little Zerg rushy guys. These, like, rhino types of creatures. Let's not blow up. I don't even know what happens if you blow up without having a headquarters, now that I'm thinking about it. I should probably avoid that. Use my mobility. We do have a way to heal. If you hold L1, you can see the various commands. Same with R1. So let's go ahead and heal. Heals 25% of our HP, I believe, on use. Throw down a bed. Yeah, exactly. There's various environmental things you have to take care of as well. Like this right here. It's mud. It's, you know, sloshy, mud-like. Get your feet stuck in them. So yeah, you're gonna have to avoid all that. You're gonna have to deal with that stuff. Keep healing. We also have mines as well, but right now we don't have a way to regenerate our mines, so kinda have to deal with it. It's also a reason why I'm not using the machine gun. That's other weapons. You can have up to 3 weapons on each arm. Not all of them can be used in conjunction with one another, but most of the firearms and ranged weapons can, so, yeah. We're gonna keep breaking all these forests and stuff we come across, so that way we can keep getting the plant biomass. Try not to miss too much of it if we can help it. From what I can tell, you don't have a limit on plant biomass as far as how much you can have. Ironium and carbonium, yes, until you build extra storage, you do have to worry about that. But, anyway. Let's continue on. Ooh, look at this. Little geothermal vent. It's good. It's gonna be for power generation. What do we have here? It's a thing. It's on our map, too. I don't know what that is. What is this? What are you? Oh, discover? Okay. I'm discovering things with my drill. Always a... Oh, jeez. Oh, Christ. No. Not like this. That was close. Woo! Okay, game is not messing around. We will continue our discovery. Jeez. Oh. Oh, hello, boys. Stone statue. Unlocked a unique item. I wonder if that's just like a cosmetic. We do have mines, by the way. They do take a moment to arm themselves. So you do have to consider that as well. Just keep using our mobility here. Dance around these fools. Yeah, melee was definitely more effective there. Anyway, we got a thing, a statue. That's cool. I don't know if it was worth me almost dying, but why not? Just goes to show, even these little tiny guys can be a threat, especially in numbers, which is their primary way of dealing with me. Trying to, anyway. Saving progress. It's already been 10 minutes, my word. Okay, so I've got my autosave set for 10 minutes, because I don't want to get an autosave notification every 5 minutes, which is the default. Let's continue. I'm curious about pathing for the enemies. Like, all these mud pits that are around, will the enemy try to path around them instead of coming at me directly, or will they try to go through the mud? It's a curious question. It's going to be very important in the metagame as far... What the hell? Stop that. You cut that out. Oh, they're dealing damage to me. A lot of damage. What is... Oh. It's these guys. Still one left. Ow! They explode on death, apparently. I think I would have found that out earlier, but whatever. At least I know. Got little artillery guys. Ooh, what the hell are those? Those were not in the prologue. And then there's stealth guys coming up from behind? Ooh, it's getting spicy, guys. What the heck are you? These don't look like the aliens, like the animals. They're almost mechanical? Oh, Christ. Okay, let's be careful here. Be very careful. Very strange. What are these things? I mean, they're organic, but definitely strange. Well, that's green and probably bad. If I know anything about alien planets, green means acid. So let's not touch that. So, what we'd like to do right now is we'd like to figure out where we want to build our base. And hopefully it'll be around both some ironium and some carbonite veins. At least for the beginning. so that way we can have a stable source of resources. Resource management will be the be-all, end-all of almost every time we play this game. Now, moving forward in the series, I probably won't spend nearly as much time as I am right now exploring, but it's literally the first time I played the game, so I want to kind of go around and see what's up. Find out what some stuff on the maps are. Okay, so these little icons, these little, you know, upside-down triangles, they're geothermal on the map. Red is, of course, bad guys. Looks like we're gonna have multiple factions of bad guys, depending on where we are, possibly. I don't know if I mentioned this before, but all the maps are procedurally generated, so... yeah. I guess, I don't know, is procedural the right word for that, or would it just be randomly generated? Because it's not procedural, I don't think, because it's not like as you're moving around the map, it's regenerating itself, and this could be an interesting place for a base. Two main entrance points, surrounded by cliffs. I might base here, I don't know. There's not a deposit of carbonium nearby, so that's kind of a negative. This place, also decent. It's got carbonium and ironium, and there's also two entrances on them. A little small, but I think that'll work. Let's get started on a base. We can move around and do stuff as we see fit, but yeah, let's get started on a base here. Okay, so what do we got here? We got our headquarters, a big ol' headquarters. Where do I want to put this? I guess, like, the best place would probably be, like, right here. Won't get in the way of too much stuff. The only problem with this spot is it's not great for, like, power generation. As far as size is concerned. Size is going to be a major factor for us. Ladies. Haha. Okay. The other thing we could do is we could take that main top point for our resources and then kind of build defenses and walls and stuff out this way. That might work. Yeah, we could kind of build there in the center starting and then branch out as we need to. Let's do that. I'm tired of running around not playing the game, looking at the amazing environments. By the way, this game, $30. $30. Incredible price for what we're looking at here.
We have to protect this building at all costs. You will be teleported here whenever I am critically damaged. There is no other backup that this building is.
We did it. Okay. So now we got a little bit of power generation here, which is nice. I'm just going to put out some power lines here for now. Of course, we'll need to get our factories up and running. Can't build it there. I don't even have the ironium for it, so we'll help them along. Okay.
You can only construct some basic power plants. Wind turbines and carbonium power plants.
Alright, so that's all hooked up now.
Wind turbines are less effective, but they work around the clock. Carbonium power plants are very effective, but they use up the deposit.
I want to build an ironium factory now.
It's best to use a combination of these power sources. We can balance energy peaks and shortages by storing excess energy in energy storages. Also, remember to connect all buildings to the power grid using energy connectors. They connect all buildings within their area of operation.
Now, the weird thing about a game like this is I don't know exactly how I'm going to do episode lengths. It's going to be a little weird, because these games, they'll last either, like, 3 minutes or 3 hours. if I'm going to be playing this like this. So I don't know how I'm going to do it. I might just do, like, I don't know, after the fact, do editing. So I might not have intros and outros where I specifically might have them before. Who knows? I don't know. Let's see. Okay. Plant biomass power plant I would like to build. But we don't have enough power for that as is. Let's do our power generation down here.
Okay, Mr. Stubborn. I guess it won't hurt to set up.
Not listening to anything they're saying. That's fine.
You're welcome, Mr. Riggs.
30 carbonium for that. I'm gonna focus on wind power for now. We'll also need to put down some energy storage as well. There's some conflicting thoughts as to how you should manage your energy storage and whatnot when it comes to this game. I've watched a lot of content on this game, by the way. So, don't expect me to not know some little things here and there. As it is right now, we need to definitely get ahead of our energy issues. I'm going to be doing both solar and wind for now. And then we'll move into some of the other things later. Like, I would like to get a plant biomass power plant up, so that way we could do that. We're still down 24 on our power generation, which is not great. It's not great. It's currently 2:40 in the a.m., in-game time, so we'll have to figure that out while we're waiting for all that to do its thing. I guess I could help out the collection. I'm not going to be building a carbonium power plant because, I don't want to, you know, use our resources for something like that if I don't have to. So, let's go ahead and do that. We'll have to get some more of this up. I think daytime starts officially at 6 a.m. You can also see in the top left-hand corner some of the stats for the things. This will generate up to 12 energy, not including any environmental factors. And this will do 20, but as you can see, the price differences are a little bit much. But, as you probably know already, solar doesn't work when there's no sun. I know, crazy, right? It's amazing how that works. But anyway, let's get into this. We'll probably need a energy connector here for these little dudes. There you go. Alright, so solar will eventually turn on here pretty soon anyway. It's 5 in the morning. Yeah, that's right. 3 hours over the course of a couple minutes while I'm fumbling around. You guys love it. Okay, right now we are positive on our energy. Oh my goodness. We're going to go ahead and also put down some storage as well. It does cost a little bit for that, but that's fine. I think getting some more carbonium factories up here would be a good idea. Mr. Riggs, I'm going to need you to calm down. I got some basics I need to work through first. R2 to rotate buildings. I don't know if I can even get this one to fit here. Probably not. Our ironium storage is full. Okay, can I build this here? Here? No. It's probably too close to the base for that. It's a little ugly, but whatever. We'll deal with it. Storage. Right. We're gonna need storage. Costs 100 carbonium. That's actually not an insignificant amount for right now. An armory. We're going to need an armory soon-ish. Let's go ahead and just put this down, I don't know, someplace a little out of the way would probably be nice, because I don't think I need to access the armory, like, physically very much. So we could probably, I don't want to put it there, because I'm going to have defenses there, but we'll go ahead and put it, I don't know, here. I suppose. I can walk past it, so it's not that big a deal. So. Okay. We'll deal with that as is. I don't think I need another Ironium mine just yet. Some of this surplus area that I've got here, I'm going to be using for storage if possible. And I can fill up some of this other area with, like, you know, this type of stuff, where I'm not necessarily going to have other uses for that space. It'll help with our overall storage and stuff like that, too. So we're at 11.2k as far as our storage of energy is concerned. Does each one of these give me 10,000? Yeah, it does. 10,000 energy. That's not too bad. Let's go ahead and plop a couple more of these down. And eventually, we're going to also want to get that geothermal vent, which I'm curious about how effective that's going to be, considering it's, as it says, infinite. That will be interesting. Okay. Armory's done. I think we can select this too. Yep. Not too bad. We can also turn it on and off, I believe, if necessary. Yeah, you can stop usage of it and it will stop consuming energy. If you look at the top left-hand corner, or sorry, the bottom left-hand corner, you can see all the various stats. Right now the upkeep is minus one ironium, minus one carbonium, and energy. So we will have to stay on top of that, seemingly. If that's the case, if it's going to be taking that type of resource, we will put down another ironium ore factory. Yeah, and we're going to need to worry about walls now. Lovely. Everybody loves walls. I don't think I need to worry about a rift portal just yet. How do I want to do this as far as walling right now? Of course. It looks like our presence has been noticed. Ashley, we don't have a lot of defensive structures. Prepare to fight. That's fine. We'll have to handle this ourselves. Remember to use repair kits if necessary. So we'll go ahead and put these down. I guess I should put some gates down, but eh, it is what it is. So bottom right hand corner, we've got some enemies coming our way. Let's go ahead and actually, yeah, let's extend it down straight down. So that way we could just block it off there. Gonna need to put a gate in here, probably. It's a good idea to have gates on all of your main wall structures. And we're gonna need turrets as well. So let's go ahead and put some of these down. We're gonna need to also worry about power in this general area. Oh, here's the bad guys. Let's deal with them.
I'm skeptical about the procedures for prepping this planet for colonization. We may not have to start the nature after the Yellowstone eruption, but that doesn't mean we shouldn't try to preserve the ecosystem.
Earth is barely habitable at this point. We have to secure Galatea 37 for colonization and resource extraction as soon as possible.
Okay, so we'll have to deal with those.
That's not entirely true. Other rift-breaking missions have already secured a number of resource-rich planets for humanity.
Okay, so we're gonna have to also prioritize. Oh, I can finally put down a plant biomass generator. Let's go ahead and put one of those down. That way we can just get some extra power generation where necessary.
I know what has to be done. That's not the point. Galatea has to be prepared for colonization. I don't doubt that. If I didn't come here myself,
ah, dang it,
someone else would have. I believe that we can do this
some of the
better way.
Placement's a little weird.
And secure the necessary resources to set up the rift station. But we don't have to destroy all the wildlife we encounter. Humanity doesn't need another stripped-down factory world if we want to progress as a species.
I Can't help but agree with Ashley here. Okay, we've got 31k for power generation. We at least need to have enough power generation to last us the night. But right now we don't have a whole lot of things sucking power out of our base, so we don't need to super duper worry about that just yet. But we will.
If you'd like to construct more advanced buildings, you'll have to upgrade the headquarters. Unfortunately, this process.
I'm just gonna get a wall straight down this way.
These creatures are clearly drawn to our energy emissions, so it will be like an alarm bell for them. We should strengthen our defenses before upgrading the HQ.
Yep. Working on it. Ah, man, we do not have enough carbonium. That is going to be a problem, isn't it? For a second is not a lot. We are probably going to have to also start branching off into other areas for carbonium acquisition. So positive 220 power, that's pretty good. But we are gonna need more. So let's go ahead and see about that. Let's just do this. There we go. Steel storage is full. You don't have to worry too much about how your resources get to your base, unlike something like Factorio and things like that. So it's definitely light in terms of those aspects, but yeah, that's never really the purpose of this type of a game anyway, let's be honest here. We also are probably going to need more storage too, aren't we? Aren't we? Because right now our carbonium is filling up, but our ironium is currently empty. Or not empty, rather full. So let's go ahead and deal with that. We're also going to need more of these AI hubs. These enable you to build more of your turrets and all that. So right now we're only 20 up on our power, but we are full of our storage for our power, so that's not too bad. So we're going to have to build more stuff, as per usual. Right now, probably a decent amount of our actual power being generated is from our plant biomass, if I had to hazard a guess, because this thing generates 100 energy a second. So when we run out of plant biomass, which we do have 1,258 of that, so 1,250 seconds of power generation for that, but we are going to have to supplement that with other sources, i.e., you know, solar, wind, things like that. Carbonium, if you're feeling spicy. But again, I'm probably not going to use that because that doesn't generally mesh with my gameplay style when it comes to these types of games, because I would rather use those resources towards something that's renewable, like bullets and such. So we're going to have to deal with that. Speaking of bullets, you're also going to have to deal with supplying ammo to your turrets as well. Let me see. These use up, I think I should be able to see. Upkeep, cost to shoot minus one. Now, I don't know exactly what goes into all of those, but yeah. Oh, and as far as upgrades are concerned, you do need to upgrade your headquarters first before you can actually do all that stuff. So let's go ahead and, I don't know, put some more turrets down. Probably a good idea. Those are going to suck up quite a bit of power for us, unfortunately. Yeah, we're already running low into our actual storage here. We're at minus 8. Oh, well, actually, it'll be a little bit less than that because we're going to be also adding this in. Okay. So that part's done. We're going to need to get the rest of these built for our defenses. Normally, you don't have this much time in a game as you're playing to get your base and all that stuff up because you're constantly going to be under attack. This is the campaign, though, so we don't have to super worry about all of that just yet. It's going to be relatively easy-peasy in the beginning, at least I would imagine. We'll make sure we line this with power nodes. There we go. Because we are going to be putting turrets down over here as well. I think for the time being, the northern side of things, I can defend it myself. But that's obviously not going to be a permanent solution. And I will be moving this because I hate it when that happens. Okay, let's go ahead and just put this one down here. We're gonna need more AI hubs. And more wind power, apparently. I mean, not really, because we do have enough surplus to run everything, at least for now, but we always want to try and be positive on all of our resources. Especially power. Power is very important. So, yeah. Fun stuff. Let's go ahead and, I don't know, kind of want to keep these all in line somewhat. There we go. That will definitely put us in the positive, as far as our energy usage is concerned. We need to upgrade our headquarters. That is going to summon bad guys to fight us. So we will deal with that as we need to. I don't know if the AI is actually smart enough to use this little U-bend over here. I would assume that they are, just through sheer quantity. Kind of like monkeys on typewriters. Eventually they'll work. They'll produce the complete works of Shakespeare. But, anyway. Let's see. I should probably do something about this. Right? I mean, I'm not going to be using it as an interest in exit, so it doesn't really matter for that, because I've got this. I don't know. If it happens, it happens. If it doesn't, it doesn't. Is what it is. Over here, though, I think... Well, we're going to need more AI hubs. So let's just find some random places for these. Those are going to take power as well. How much power exactly? 20 a second. So right now we're at plus 264, but really that's plus 164 if you want to get technical, because we are dealing with our actual little our plant biomass, which is running for the time being, but I think for now I'm going to turn this off, get us a more accurate count, and if we need the extra power, I'll turn it back on. How about that? What do you guys think about that? That's right. So, we'll get a more accurate look at what our general power is, and if we need it, we'll get more. So, right now we're kind of comfy with where our base is at, what we're producing. So let's do some more exploration while we're kind of going around. We are going to want to build quite a few things here as we're progressing. Namely, where is it? These things, like the communication hub. The air is getting dense. A fog is forming up. And the rift station. Ooh, that's interesting. I haven't seen the rift station before. That's new. But yeah, the communication hub for one is definitely what we're going to want to upgrade to. I mean, it's not that hard to see. I mean, we have a... You know, bird's eye view of our camera here. Never mind, the fog is very intense. I was just kidding, it's pea soup. I can't see crap. That's pretty funny. I was like, the fog's not that bad. Just kidding. It's horrible. It's horrible and I hate it. Let's build some stuff. I love how the second I'm like, let's go explore, the game's like, but how can you explore if you can't see? I'm like, what do you mean I can't see? I can see, but never mind. Can't see. Can't see anything. Everything sucks and the world hates me. Okay. Anyway, let's throw some storage down because we're going to need it. Do these take power? I don't think they do. They're just buckets. Buckets don't take any actual power usage. That is a direct quote from me, the Zanzibar Man. Buckets don't take power. Feel free to take that in and out of context however you want. Unless you're talking about a different language, in which case I can't help you with that as far as context is concerned, because in Tagalog, bucket means something along the lines of fuck. So. Anyway, there's another geothermal vent. I can't see any. Oh, hello, bad guys. They can see me. I wonder if their visibility goes down at all. Oh, hi, guys. Oh, fog's clearing up now. That's lovely. Okay. I bet that also hampers our ability to generate power via solar as well. Okay. It's gonna really suck at nighttime when we lose our wind, because that is a thing. Earlier they were saying that the wind felt dense or something like that, so. That's interesting. When these guys get enraged, aggroed, they have like undercarriage red lights going on. Very interesting. Some of those invisible guys are here. Oh, hey, boys. My little slingy boys, chillax. Okay, I'm really digging this so far. This feels good. Feels good to play. The controls are real responsive. It's doing what I want it to do. What the hell is going on over here? More of these guys. What is that sound? Something happening over here to the right. Oh, it's you! Hello! Hey, buddy. What's your thing? You seem angry. Oh, look at these guys trying to flank me like the little stealthy bastards that they are. I do like how they lose their camouflage when they get damaged like Predator. That's pretty neat. Something tells me this guy like is gonna hurt a lot. See how you like a mine. Oh, you do not care. Okay, the sword seems to be doing some work. Okay. You gonna explode? No? I don't know why I felt like he was gonna explode. Oh, we didn't even get anything for killing you? You're just a time sink? Got it. Got it. This map is going, like, way further than I thought it was going to, by the way. Like, way further. Okay, so they're like two sword strikes apiece. I remember these yellow things. They explode. We got little mud monsters. Mud monsters. What's up, my muddy bros? Really? Surprising. Let's put some mines down. Have them walk into that. Come on, you little bastards. Who wants a piece? These guys want a piece. Ah, oh, God, they want the whole damn thing. I love the new enemies we're seeing. I've never seen these guys before, and even the videos that I've watched. So it's really nice to know that the devs were kind of keeping some stuff a little, a little closer to the cuff when it comes to reveals. That's pretty neat to me. These guys are mean looking. Look at those chompers on them. They got some mandible type teeth. teeth going on. Also, I don't know if you guys noticed or not, but some of these enemies are different colors. That denotes that they're getting tougher. Little shark dogs. Let's see if those guys remind me of sharks, but dogs. Shark dogs. But yeah, some of these guys are going from red to green. Stuff like that. Like these guys. No, it takes more than one fully charged shot to kill them now. So, you know, they probably have like 1.5 HP. 2x HP. I don't know. Oh, look at you. You... Ooh, okay. Let's avoid you. Yo. These golem-type enemies are mean. Yo, what the hell is that? What are you? I feel very unsafe. Okay. Terrifying. Let's go back to base. I'm scared. I am scared of these things. They are scary to me. Okay. A lot of Ironium out that way that we went, but that's about it. Not a whole lot. I was kind of hoping to run into, like, I don't know, some boss enemies or, like, some of the stuff from the prologue, like the big bad monsters, you know? Haven't seen any mods as well, like the ones that we saw in the prologue. And if you guys are curious about this game, the prologue is free to download if you are wanting to try it out. And I ran all this way here without even remembering that I could just literally open up the map and just teleport to the base. Whatever. Anyway, we're back. I thought I destroyed these things already. Get out of the way. Get out of here. Okay, let's throw down some more defenses. Sounds like a good idea. What do you guys think? One thing I don't know is whether or not these defenses can shoot through each other or over each other. Don't know that yet. Okay. I'll need to throw down some power gen. Eventually, I'm going to fully internalize the control scheme for this game, so it'll be a lot smoother to watch. Yeah, we need more power gen. Sun should be coming up. Let's see exactly what time it starts generating. Come on. 6:30? 7? 8 o'clock? Jeez, I really thought 6 o'clock would have been the time. Because, you know, video game logic. Any moment now. 7 o'clock? No, 8 o'clock? Jeez. Is it, like, physically when the actual sun gets here? Oh, yeah, our base heals us. No? Maybe it's 8 o'clock. That's crazy. Oh. Okay. That's fine. We can do that. 8 o'clock? 8 o'clock? We are generating plus power right now, which is good. Okay, yeah, 8 o'clock. 8 o'clock and we're up at 316. You'll love to see it. I do have some more ability to put down turrets, so let's go ahead and just put some of these down. I'm going to put one here just to see if it actually will shoot the way that I want it to. If it does, then great. If it doesn't, then great. It is what it is. There we go. So we will be getting an attack here in 1 minute. I think after that attack, I will end the episode, because it's been about an hour now. 50 minutes, actually. Should I wall this in? I don't know if I should wall this in or not. I should definitely do something with my actual resources. I'm not really doing anything right now. I'm just kind of marveling at the game world, because it's beautiful. Damn it. It is a very nice looking game, though. Like, very nice looking. I appreciate how this game looks. Feels good. But yeah, like I said earlier, I think that this game is only out on PlayStation 5 and Xbox Series X. So, you know. Let's see. Got 18 seconds here. It is what it is. Where are they? Wonder where they're going to be coming from. I don't have the ability to use my radar like I had in the prologue. Oh, can I change my appearance? No? Guess I don't have that movement skill. Dash. Apparently there's other types of movement skills, which is pretty neat. What do we have here? Energy sensors. Mod drop rate plus 20%. We haven't even seen any mods yet, so they are a thing, but wait a second. Did I attack drones? Repair drones? Guys, there's drones. There's drones, everybody. There's drones. Shotgun, small machine gun, blaster. What else do we have here? Sword. Armor plating. We don't have armor plating. Let's go ahead and make this. Nice. Now, from what I know, all these stats are re-rollable, right? So you can see where this says 105 to 120. And, you know, same thing with, I would imagine, the crit chance and stuff like that. Let's build a shotgun. 486 DPS. I mean, that's kind of on the lower side, to be honest. But whatever. It's fine for now. Let's go ahead and grab our shotgun. There we go. Equip that. We can disassemble stuff too. Not too bad. Let's do this. You can't shoot through these walls, by the way. You need to build these right here. Heightened wall floors to do that. I'll take a look at one of those real quick while we wait for the enemies to show up. And then, yeah, now I can shoot over this. All walls you can melee through, though, if you have melee with enough range, as is. I guess we could... Oh, no, I hear him. Here they come. We'll just come out here and give our turret some backup. I don't even think our buildings got damaged. Oh, a little bit. Little bit. It's not too bad, though. Ah, it's all good, little mama. We just now got into some of this, but yeah, I think as far as this episode is concerned, I am going to leave it there. If you guys liked it, feel free to hit that like button, leave a comment down below, so on and so forth. If you're watching on the stream, stick around. I am going to keep on playing, because I'm going to be playing this probably for hours.